Hello and welcome to the Alltech Coppens Aqua Centre, which represents the cornerstone of Alltech's commitment to aquaculture. Here is where we develop the feeds of the future through the application of precision nutrition technologies. Before we take you through a tour of our next generation digestibility system, it's important to understand how we frame our research. We do this by the four pillar concept: palatability, performance, pollution control, and planet. All of the research that we do here at the Alltech Coppens Aqua Centre has to fall under all of those categories. By doing that, we ensure that the research that is performed is applicable both to our feed formulation and also to the needs of our customers in order to develop the feeds of the future to suit every farming environment.
The first and probably the most important pillar is palatability. It is designated as the first pillar since uneaten feed has a negative effect on the subsequent pillars of performance, pollution control, and planet. When we quantify palatability, we divide this into two important metrics: taste and maximum feed intake. Taste is the short-term effect of a certain feed or raw material on the feed intake of the fish and their ability to adapt to this taste. Data from research suggests that the negative or positive taste effect of a given feed is predominantly observed over a short period of time. A few days after the adaptation to taste, the maximum feed intake of a given feed can be quantified. This is of the utmost importance to the fish farmer since this determines the maximum growth potential. However, it is important to note that it is not only the taste that affects the maximum feed intake of the feed. The maximum feed intake is strongly related to the energy level in a feed. Higher energy levels result in a lower maximum feed intake. The second pillar is performance. The energy level, which is responsible for 70% of the feed cost, is the principal factor that determines the performance potential of a feed. Fish feed contains a certain amount of energy, which is mainly derived from the dietary macronutrients, protein, fat, and carbohydrates. This dietary energy has been used as a predictor for growth in feed formulation for years. But when a feed is eaten by the fish, some of this energy is not digested and therefore not available to the fish. Of the digestible energy, again a portion is lost as the result of metabolic processes. Therefore, the dietary energy which is finally available for both maintenance and growth of the fish is called net energy. Within our research centre, we determine the net energy level of all of our feeds and all of the ingredients that we use. After the feed is consumed by the fish and digested and utilised for growth, the logical effect is that the fish excretes waste products in the form of feces and ammonia. Indigested feed and ammonia excreted via the gills pollute their living environment, the water. It is this third pillar of pollution control that can dictate the difference between a good feed and an excellent feed, particularly in modern RAS systems. In today's aquaculture industry, the quality of fish feed is not only determined by the indicators that are directly related to the fish, so palatability, performance, pollution control. The effect that the feed has on the planet has become of increasing importance. It is often seen as a luxury to produce, buy, or use sustainable products, but it is now increasingly becoming a necessity if we want to stabilize the potential negative effect of our industry on the planet. To make sure that we are able to precisely measure all metrics related to our four pillars, we have to ensure that the feeds we want to compare within a given trial represent the only variable. Therefore, it is important to ensure all other parameters are constant, such as the maintenance of consistent optimal water quality throughout the whole trial,